Question of that. Were you in there amongst all of those trees?
Just observing.
Just observing, okay. Yes.
Yeah, I saw someone running
through
a crowd
for
someone else on the street.
Fantastic. Interesting. Very good.
Yeah.
Busy European cobblestone streets with a video fast forward.
Oh, great picture. Thank you, Winston.
Yeah.
Cinderella with the mouses helping.
Yeah. I saw swirling colors, kind of like colors chasing each other.
Okay, swirling colors chasing each other. Yes,
A creek, water coming downhill through in the woods and the sun shining in on it.
Oh, absolutely beautiful. Thank you.
Horses running.
Horses running. Okay, I'm going to ask you to take a second look. What color were your horses? Mixed collection?
Obviously they are pretty questions about the strain.
Yes, good, good, yes.
Fine cigar lounge.
That tells a lot about you, Jeff. Hey, excellent. Fine cigar lounge. Okay. Was there anything? Consulting ourselves, right? We're wondering how do we feel here, what's happening up here. And I ask a couple of questions because the more attention we pay to the details of what's happening here, the more real, the more important they are in our own lives, the more likely they are to become part of ourselves, help us to think anew. So it's time to up the ante. Add a matter, a measure of passion and commitment to this work of imagination. So allow me to set the stage. I will impersonate a man. I invite you to come enter into my imagination and see him. His name is Alonso Quijada, a country squire, no longer young. Bony hollow face, eyes that burn with the fire of inner vision. Being retired, he has much time for books, and he studies them from morn till night, and oftentimes through the night as well. And all he reads oppresses him, fills him with indignation of man's murderous ways towards man. He broods and broods. So finally, his brains dry up. He lays down the melancholy burden of sanity and conceives the strangest project ever imagined. To be a knight errant and sally forth into the world to right all wrongs. No longer shall he be plain among the honor, but a dauntless knight known as Don Quixote de la Mancha. Hear me now. With his valley on gray and rose,
It is she. Dear lady, fair maiden, I dare not gaze fully upon thy countenance, lest I be blind. But I implore thee, speak once thy name, for I have not my spectacles, and cannot read thy name. Speak low. I fear that my lady jests. It is perhaps the name of your serving maid. Is it thy true name? My lady wishes to put me to the test. Oh, sweet sovereign of my captive heart, I shall not fail thee.